The BYU Cougars have not lost a game since the opener of the 1983 season, but the defending national champions are still fighting to gain respectability. And that could come if Pac-10 power UCLA becomes their 26th straight victim. Coach Lavelle Edwards is impressed with UCLA's secondary and says they're much quicker than Boston College, which gave up 508 yards last week.
They're much quicker in the secondary and a much better secondary than BC. I think up front would be, I'm not sure they're either better or whatever, it's hard to say, but they're good up front as well, but their secondary will be much better than Boston College's.
This is the youngest Bruin team Coach Donahue has had in years. Only 7 upperclassmen will be starting for UCLA. BYU will have twice that many. But that's not UCLA's only problem going into their season opener.
Our football team is not healthy coming into the BYU game. We have probably 4 starters out of the game, maybe 5. Most of whom I think will be back for the conference. So I'm anticipating that our team's going to be a little bit better 3 or 4 weeks from now than it is today. So we're going to go up to BYU, play as hard and fast, as furious as we can, and let the chips fall where they fall. We're playing a team that's won 25 straight, and we might be the 26th victim, or then again, we may end the streak. Who knows?
Like BYU, UCLA had its share of offensive weapons. Running back Gaston Green, wideouts Mike Sherrard, and Willie Flipper Anderson all starred in the Bruins' potent attack. Coming up later, we'll take a look at Robbie Bosco's rise from obscurity. But now we present the 1985 matchup between UCLA and BYU right here on ESPN Classic.
Welcome to Cougar Stadium, home of the BYU Cougars and host to the UCLA Bruins. Let's join the opening kickoff here on ESPN Classic.
The start of another college football season, home season that is, for BYU. The Cougars winners last week against Boston College. We have there, you see the weather, partly cloudy today. In fact, it's beautiful weather for a football game. We have a sellout crowd, and many, many other people would like to be to this football game. Getting tickets this week was a real adventure in itself. We have Craig Garrick back are with us this year, who played on the offensive line for BYU, and Steve Young, former All-American quarterback here too. Steve, what do you look for?
I look for a very close contested game in the first half, but I think the experience and the liveliness from last week's win will prove BYU in the second half will do very well.
Okay, UCLA receives. That's Bob Garibaldi, who took it and ran it back out to the 23. He's the son of a former Major League Baseball player now playing football for the Bruins of UCLA. And Craig, what kind of a game do you look for?
I look for high scoring from BYU. I don't think we're going to have any trouble putting points on the board this game. I think as long as UCLA thinks they're going to run the ball, I don't think that they're going to get very many points on the board. We just have too good of a linebacking core this year to run against.
Their quarterback is Dave Norrie. He's a fifth-year senior and starting really for the first time. He's in limited action in his career at UCLA. They open up a pretty good hole in the first down and go right up the middle. They do have a very good running back in the person of
Gaston Green,
but this one was Mel Farr, number 22, and Mel's dad played professional football.
You'll see the replay here, Jay. The thing about BYU last week against Boston College, you saw before Boston College got behind, was their Boston College's success running the football with Troy Stratford. Here there is another hole up the middle. BYU will have to shore up that running defense, and those linebackers will have to play real well.
A 10-yard gain. It's first and 10 on the 32-yard line. Norrie still with the ball, running the option. That's Green, and it's a loss this time as Rob Ledanko shot through and got him.
Ledanko had it read the whole way. He saw it coming. He was right out there on top of things, and he just starts to salivate when he sees those kinds of things coming.
Ledanko had an excellent game against Boston College. Rob is a senior who transferred to BYU, would have started last year, but he was hurt and redshirted.
You know, Jay, if you go down the BYU roster from man to man, you'll notice a tremendous experience that BYU's got on this team here. Many, many fifth-year seniors, mission returnees. It's a very experienced ball club.
4-yard loss, second and 14. Norrie, the quarterback, sends a man in motion. That's Green. Back to throw, swings it out to Green, juggles it, catches it, and is down at the line of scrimmage. Coming up to make the stop for BYU, the right cornerback, Rodney Thomas. Good play by Rodney. Rodney's another new man in that defensive secondary for BYU.
Yeah, Rodney stepped in there and with a lot of confidence, has done a good job, had a great spring, and looks like he's really going to do a good job this fall.
David Norrie is 6'5", a senior, weighs 212. He's from Portland, Oregon. He and Matt Stevens were in a dead heat for quarterback coming into this fall, and he finally won the starting nod. Third down, about 13. He's back to throw. Pressure comes up the middle. Will not get the yardage for the first down. Oh, he was hit hard that time. He was hit hard by Jeff Sprouls.
You know, I think this first series was very important for Norrie, Jay, to get off to a good start. You see he dropped back and didn't even get it. He had good protection. He didn't give himself a chance to look downfield. He just saw an opening and started to run. And now, I'll tell you, look on the replay right here. You'll see him. He has protection, but there he goes. And you'll see that that's a tendency for a young quarterback, even though he's a senior, his first time on the playing field, is to just go ahead and turn the ball upfield.
Their punter is Harold Barkate. The snap a little low, but he has it, and here's the kick. Booms it. It's fairly short, but takes a UCLA roll and goes out of bounds down around the 25-yard line. And BYU will take over right now. Barkate from Lancaster, California, is a redshirt freshman. A lot of young players on this UCLA team.
And it's unusual for UCLA, because usually they like to breed their guys through a 5-year redshirt program. And Coach Donahue did say that this is his youngest team in a long time, and that's not good for a first game out. I think BYU will be glad to have played UCLA early in the season like this rather than later in the season as this team starts to mature.
Here's the starting offense for BYU, and there's going to be a momentary break. We'll get Craig to talk a little bit about Dave Wright, Dave King, Keith McCullough, Dave Tidwell, Scott Robinson. Wright's the only returnee. Craig, what about these young men?
Well, Jay, they've all seen a lot of action. They've all played a lot together. Even though they haven't started on the varsity team as a unit, they've seen a lot of action as individuals, and they're all real good players. And once they came together and to play, I think they're just going to do a super job all the way around once they get a few games under their belts.
There's the starters for the UCLA team. There are three UCLA young men who would have started who are out with injury. Let's see, they have a cornerback. In fact, I think they have a couple of cornerbacks who are out because of injury, and they have some inexperience in the backfield.
Now, that's the same situation, Jay, that the Boston College had last week, and I'm sure that the BYU coaches and players will try to take advantage of that.
Robbie Bosco, quarterback, wants the crowd to quiet down a little bit. He has Haymuli and Smith as the setbacks, two men wide, one on each side. And here's the first play. Bosco fakes the draw, passes, and it's caught. Diving catch on the sidelines to Lake Haymuli, the fullback.
Jay, you'll notice something very unusual with BYU in the last couple of years. They've started to stand up. Even the linemen are in up stances. The tight end is standing up. Both. Here you see just a play action fake by Robbie Bosco. Good blocking, and Lake Haymuli makes a great catch for 4 yards. What I was trying to say is, you notice that most of the men on the offensive line and in this, everyone's standing up, and it's a visionary type thing where they want to have everyone to see what is happening downfield, and they can make their adjustments to what's happening rather than their head down into the ground like a lot of other teams.
Sika Hammond in motion, second down. Robbie a screen. Haymuli is hit right away, however. Robbie had to throw it quicker that time than he wanted to. Somebody right on top of him, that was Tommy Taylor.
Yeah, Tommy Taylor had it read the whole way through. He was just hanging out there low, and the guard coming out on the pull ran right by him and was looking for no one to block.
Craig, they've liberalized the blocking rules again this year. The retreat blocking, you can now do that on the run as well as the pass.
Mm-hmm. I think it's a good idea.
I thought you would.
Gives the offensive line a little,
get those hands
little
out there,
opportunity.
Third and nine, Bosco to throw. They get him this time. So the UCLA defense does a pretty good job on the BYU Cougars, led by Eric Smith, the outside linebacker who forced that play.
Yeah, he just drove right over the top of our running back and just drove him right into the quarterback, took him right into the quarterback with him.
Steve, when you played UCLA down there 2 years ago, at the start of the game, they started six defensive backs and gave you the run.
Well, we had thrown so much the past few games, and we did run very well. In fact, I think we had over 200 yards.
Coming, it's blocked.
Boy, they really came at the Cougars that time. They blocked the ball. The ball's free all over the place. But UCLA will have it. So the Bruins block a Cougar punt, and they really put a rush on.
Now, yeah, there were three or four guys back there.
We've got to remember, too, that when UCLA gets inside the 40-yard line, they have a young man named John Lee who's only missed once out of 47 attempts, I think, in his career.
I think Cougar fans, in memory of Lee Johnson, the last kicker for the 4 years at BYU, they knew him as a great field goal kicker. John Lee is the same kind of a player. When they're inside the 20 or the 30, it's an automatic 3 points for UCLA.
He may be the best place kicker ever to play college football. His statistics say that. First and 10 on the 15-yard line. A pitch back to Green. Green tries to turn the corner, and he's hit hard. Gains a couple, however.
Yeah, Sean Knight just strung that play out all the way along and fought off his block just at the right moment, just as he was turning up field to make the tackle.
Ken Smith there to help, too.
It's just a power sweep, Jay, to the right. One thing about UCLA with an inexperienced quarterback down inside the 20 the first time of the season, I think you're going to see them run the football in because that's the thing they have the most confidence in. Now, you might prove me wrong right here, Noy, but I think they'll run the ball, try to punch it in on the ground.
Second down, about 9. Right up the middle this time, and he bulls his way down to the 8-yard line. Might be to the 7-yard line.
And yeah, they're just blowing our nose guard just 3 or 4 yards back on the double team.
Coach Donahue from UCLA told the Utah media this week that after having played BYU, the thing he respected was their strength and their defense. He said, we know they can score, but the strength and the defense a couple of years ago surprised him a little.
That's always been underrated as our defense in the past few years. And they've always been a great defense, and they've always been very sound. They don't take many chances, and you'll see them play basic defense and just play it very, very well.
Third down, about 4 yards for the first down. Noria quarterback has him set. Man in motion to the left. Here's the snap. Still has the ball. Throws it into the end zone. Clear out of the end zone. Wow. He threw that about 10 yards out of the end zone.
There again, I think he's just very excited. He saw a man open for a second downfield. Norrie's going to have take a few passes to get into the groove. You'll see him set up and just let the ball go way too high. I'll give him a couple of possessions to get his feet on the ground.
Here's John Lee, who has made, 96 of 97 extra points in his career, 69 in a row, and he never misses inside the 40.
Well, we'll see if he can get another one right here.
Here's the kick. And it is good.
Now,
he kicked a field goal last year with less than a minute to go to win the Fiesta Bowl.
Well, the one thing about great kickers is you see them come on the field so relaxed. You know that they've got a little set of things that they do every time they come on the field. And you'll see his leg swing very fluid, and there's no jerky motion about anything that he does. And I think that's why he's such a consistent kicker.
Double-checking that stat, he kicked 42 out of 43 in his career inside the 40-yard line. We'll pause for just a moment. Be back right after this with more BYU football. Oh, 16-yard field goal by John Lee. Lee was born in Korea, is it not?
I think so.
And he played on their national championship Little League baseball team. Here's the kickoff. Did it go out of bounds before it got in the end zone?
Nope. Touchback in the 20.
Again, there's a change in that rule this year. Last year, if you kicked it out of the end zone, it came out to the 30-yard line. That rule was thrown out. So it's back to the 20 no matter what this year.
You're looking at those highlights of those great moments a couple minutes ago, Jay. Tells me why BYU fans are so loyal. It's easy to be loyal when there's so much winning going on.
That's
kind
right.
of fun to be a fan
well,
with a very successful organization like this.
Watch for those. Our producer-director, Russ Murrow, has put together quite a few of them. We'll see others during the game. We might even see one Steve Young was involved in.
I'll tell you what, that's why I come back to Pro every chance I get. It's a very exciting place.
First and 10, Brigham Young, the 20. They trail 3-0. Bosco on the draw. That's Hey Mooley. Big hole up the middle, out to the 26-yard line. Wayman Hamilton had a big game, I think, against UCLA down there running wise.
I think it was also Casey Tiamalo on that
Casey.
Same draw play. This is called a draw trap. Craig could probably explain the blocking a lot better than I can.
A super job by the center, Keith McCullough, just getting his guy to take an outside release and all the guys over there on the left side taking their guys upfield.
Now, Craig, you'll agree that what BYU's trying to do is take advantage of the hard charging front line of the UCLA Bruins. They sacked Robbie a couple of times and put pressure on the first drive. They're going to take advantage of that.
Well, he's back to throw this time. Gets it off. It's caught by Hanuli. Out to the 35 to the 40-yard line. And listen to the crowd. Wow. So far, Hanuli's been the offense for BYU. He had caught, see, he caught four last week against Boston College.
Watch Laquay come right out of the backfield. Robbie back on his heels. Goes ahead and just flips it out there. And Laquay, even though he's a smaller guy, very compact, very strong, he's really got great touch and great feel in those hands and makes himself a great receiver out of the backfield.
That was a great job by both guards coming out on the fan and picking up the outside linebackers. They both blitzed on that play.
Henley made the tackle for UCLA. Bosco fires, completes it to Sikahema. And they don't gain much on that, maybe a yard. Right now, the passes from BYU so far in a game have been pretty much to the running backs on the sidelines.
Well, I think they're taking advantage of the par charge. They're not taking any deep drops because of the great penetration the first drive. I think they're going to just take the short passes, whittle away the yards so that Robbie doesn't have to stand back there too long and take the chance of a sack.
7:40 to go in the first quarter. It's UCLA 3, Brigham Young nothing. Cougars after their 26th straight victory and their 17th straight victory in this stadium. Bosco to throw, pretty good protection. Gets it off, it's cut out to the 50-yard line. I think it's by Sikahema again.
UCLA's in that 3-4 defense, and it's hard for any team to stop BYU on those short passes in a 3-4 type of defense.
Not quite enough for the first down. It'll be third and less than a yard at midfield.
Sikahema gets out to the midfield stripe. It'll be third
Bosco
down,
at quarterback. We have Haymooley and Sikahema, the running backs. You have Edwards wide to the right. And we have two tight ends in, Molini and Lindley. Bosco bootlegging, looking, throws. It's caught by Molini. 40, down to the 35-yard line. And they fooled him that time.
I'll tell you, BYU's been running that offensive play on third and short for years and years. All it is a run-pass option. And you'll see the one, if you get a replay, you'll see Robbie Bosco pressured to throw by the cornerback. They're playing off the cornerback. Now watch, Robbie gets pressured. The guy that he let go is Trevor Molini right there. And so it's a do or die situation for the cornerback. If he stays, Robbie can go ahead and run for the first down. If he doesn't, then it opens up that passing lane.
It forces him to make a decision.
Exactly.
James Washington made the tackle. He's a sophomore, and they say one of the best athletes on this team. Bosco looking to pass. Chased out of the pocket and wrestled to the ground this time at the 41-yard line. That'll be a loss of 6 or 7 yards. That's Bosco. Jim Whaler who pulled him down.
Jim Whaler.
Jay, Coach Chow during last week told me that they were thinking that they might roll out Robbie a little bit more this game, get him outside the pocket and take advantage of his running ability, and we might look for that a little bit more
17.
As the game progresses.
Steve, how many defensive backs are they using? They're using five? Let's see, one, two, three.
I think they're staying with a 3-4.
Yeah, there's
Jay.
3-4, that's yeah. Right. Okay. BYU one setback this time, two men wide to the left, one in the slot. Bosco to throw, does throw over the middle. It is caught for the 28-yard line, and that's by Sikahema. So Robbie really working with his running backs. By a senior from Mesa.
It's a little option route by Vi, breaks inside. He's so quick, he's very tough to cover one-on-one, and that's an easy 8-10 yards.
Tommy Taylor tackling. Bosco is 7-for-7 now.
I think one of the reasons they're not going to 5 and 6 defensive backs, Jay, is their strength right now in their defense is at linebacker, and they don't want to take out one of their stronger players with an inexperienced player in the defensive backfield.
Third and 5 for BYU. Bellini wide to the right. Kozlowski to the left. Bosco bootlegging, looking downfield. He's looking for a block. He'll run it himself. He's down at the 18-yard line. And I think it was Sikahema who threw the block. Down Brigham Young. Marcus Turner tackled him.
Here's what we just mentioned, Jay, with Robbie moving on the outside, run pass option. He's capable of running the ball. We called him crazy legs last year. You'll see that he's just pointing out the block that he wants to get. Breaks inside that block right there. A great block by Vi. Picks up the
line
down.
Did a great job getting everybody going in the opposite direction.
That's right, Craig, stick up for that dang line. They're a great group of guys, coached by a great coach.
First and 10 on the 18. Bosco fires, tipped this time. Intended for Molini, but it was tipped
for Molini.
By Tommy Taylor.
Tommy Taylor, their their touted All-American linebacker got a hand up and batted that one down.
I know he's a good player, Jay, because he was one of the fine linebackers we played against 2 years ago. And you see, he has a chance for an interception just a little bit high.
You can tell what kind of a player he is. His nickname is Freight Train. They say that's the way he hits. Cougars second and 10 on the 18-yard line. UCLA ahead 3-0. Bosco back to pass. Pretty good protection. There's the pass. It's caught. Nice catch that time by Mark Bellini under pressure at the 8-yard line.
Just a tremendous throw by Robbie Bosco into the flat. That's a long throw, especially to the wide side of the field. A tremendous arm shown there. You'll see the distance this ball has to travel just to go 12 yards. Really lets that thing fly. Look at how on target it is. Mark makes a great catch, but yet he was very well covered.
Darrell Henley tackled him. First and goal, Brigham Young on the 7-yard line. Trying to take the lead. You have Norberg to the right. In the slot on the right is Kozlowski. Two setbacks. They're split. Kozlowski goes in motion over to the left side. There's the drop, the middle. He nearly slips one tackle. Still on his feet. He bulls his way down to the six.
Locke is a strong kid, but when it's difficult when you don't get those defensive linemen upfield far enough to get the running space you need to make that play effective. Locke just kind of took it on his own and got what he could with those powerful thighs of his.
Second and goal. It's like they didn't gain anything where it's marked down. Second and goal, still on the 7-yard line. Kozlowski to the right. Bosco back to throw. Looks, fires it. Too tall that time. It's incomplete at the end of the end zone. Bellini went up and it was just off his fingertips.
Just super protection by the offensive line. He had all day back there. They had a wall set up. Just gave him beautiful protection.
I don't know how many times I told you, Craig, but it makes a quarterback's job mighty easy when he can sit back there and relax and find an open receiver and let the ball fly. It makes for a very simple situation for a quarterback and easy to be successful.
That never happened while we were playing together, did it?
I think I remember about 5 or 6 seconds on average.
Could have ate your lunch back there.
I'm out, BYU. Third and goal, bringing the play in for the Cougars is Norberg. Scott Norberg. Now there's timeout on the field with a score. UCLA 3, Brigham Young 0. We have 3.5 left to go in the first quarter. We'll be right back. UCLA ahead 3-0. While we have a minute, let's thank the BYU Cougar Club for the financial support we receive for our sports telecast. You know, the Cougar Club has over 3,500 members now, and they're in a membership drive. If you join this week between now and next Saturday, you'd get a free Cougar Club sweater, either blue or white. So our thanks to the Cougar Club, and if you're not a member, you should be. Third down play, Bosco looking. Here's the pass, and it's out of the end zone, intended for Kozlowski. But he overthrew him. There were two men on Kaz, too. So now the Cougars will try a field goal as the UCLA defense stiffens a bit.
Number 7.
3-0.
You'll notice on the replay here, Jay, they're trying to send Kaz to the corner, a route that he scored many, many touchdowns on. Robbie sees the double coverage and wants to give a chance for the field goal and lets the ball fly. You'll see both defensive players for the UCLA Bruins in position to make the play.
Trying the field goal for BYU is Gary Webster. Played at Ricks College, where he's a junior college All-American, and then went to Washington after a mission, and then transferred to BYU. He's 0 for 1 this year, field goal kicking. This one looks good. It is. So Gary Webster from Yakima, Washington, kicks it through there, and Brigham Young has tied the score on a drive that started back on the 20-yard line.
Nice placement there by Jeff Wilcox.
Kicking off for BYU is Ormsby. And to go out of bounds?
Yeah, went out of bounds on about the 5.
One thing about the kicking game for the Cougars this year, Jay, they've had to replace Lee Johnson, who was the all-purpose man at kickoffs, field goals, punts, and they've had to replace him with 3 or 4 guys that are vying for that position. And until they get settled in these first few games, I'm sure you're going to see a few mistakes.
You just can't replace a Lee Johnson or a Steve Young.
Steve Young was a kicker.
Craig Garrick has a tendency to to put the jibes in where he can. He's a good man.
Mark Ormsby, who is doing the kicking for BYU on kickoffs, is a senior from New Zealand. He
rugby player.
Right. He played rugby in high school, also in track, and walked on this year at BYU. He's an All-American rugby player, but out on the field, the first time he's ever played football. He has a very strong leg. Here's the kick. Very high. Good kick this time. All the way back to the 1 yard line. Up to the 15 and down at the 20 yard line.
UCLA, Jay, does a very interesting thing on their kickoffs. They line up most of their men right back in front of the kicker and then charge at the oncoming defenders, about six or seven of them, three quarters of the team. There's meet right at the 20-yard line. I don't know if that's tremendously effective because there's no holes for the kickoff return man to really choose from.
Steve and Craig, Coach Edwards this year told the media one time that Ormsby had never played football, but he'd played rugby. And he said after playing rugby, it'd be easy to play football. That'd be a sissy game.
Probably true.
First and 10 on the 20. Still with the ball is Norrie, looking to throw. Here's the pass. Incomplete. Overthrew the intended receiver on the sidelines, Carl Durrell. See, Durrell's their flanker back. He's a junior from San Diego. It's interesting. You look at the times that the young men from UCLA can run, and almost all of them are around 4.4, 4.5 with their speed. They're a quick team.
Very fast team. Speed is something that's very emphasized at UCLA.
Second and 10 on the 20-yard line. Norrie gives him the draw this time. He slips one tackle and gets back to the 23-yard line. Good defense by BYU, stopping Gaston Green.
Gaston read that play beautifully.
Gaston, they call a potential superstar, and it was Latakeo got him.
Green getting 3 yards on the play. It'll be third and 8 on the 22.
Latakeo, being coached by the new member of the coaching staff, Claude Bassett, just done a super job this year, stepped in, and feels right at home at the inside position.
Third and 8 for UCLA. The Bruins, a 3-3 tie in the first quarter. Norrie still with the ball, chased out of the... He lost the ball, he gets it. I think it was knocked out of his hands. Jason Buck knocked it out of his hands, I believe.
Norrie just very careless as he carries the ball. He makes the play fake, I-formation play fake right here. He sets up. The pressure comes from Sean Knight right there, or Jason Buck, and he runs into his own guy, and that's just careless football. He's trying to make a move to the outside, and that's just inexperience. And again, David Norrie, you'll see as his first collegiate game as a starter, a little bit.
Yeah, he ran into his own man,
exactly,
didn't he?
A little quick to make the move on the outside, and he's got to just settle down a little bit if he's going to be effective.
Mark
Great
Kate.
Defensive job by Kirk Gervais.
Punting from the end zone. Here's the kick. Kicks it high, not too deep. At the 50, Sikahema waiting, has it. To the 45 and no, about the 47, he's down there. So the Cougars have the ball in excellent field position after the defense really shut him off. Kirk Alexander made the hit on by Sikahema.
This is the kind of opportunity that the BYU offense just loves to have. They get the ball back early and you get it back in good field position, and this is an opportunity where you can go ahead quickly and hopefully take some air out of the other team.
Hey, talk about the schedule this year, too. Boston College, our first game, won the Cotton Bowl. UCLA won the Fiesta Bowl. Washington won the Orange Bowl. And later, we'll play the Air Force, who won the Independence Bowl. Fakes the draw. Bosco to throw. Does throw. Intercepted. Back to the 50. Back to the 40. Back to the 30. Back to the 20. He'll score. So UCLA really turned it around in a hurry as Craig Rutledge stepped in front of the intended receiver. He intercepted and ran it all the way back for a score.
You'll notice on the replay here, Jay, they're running the fake draw trap, which they've been effective all day running to Lakehe Muli, and it's just a play action fake to the tight end down the middle, and the free safety just sits and waits, sees Robbie's eyes as he releases the ball, makes a break on the ball, and then runs down the sideline. And the unfortunate thing is Robbie, as he threw the ball, was knocked down, did not realize that the ball had been intercepted, and didn't get a chance to get up and make the tackle.
Well, Craig Rutledge intercepted it. He's a junior from Placentia, California. Was a reserve last year. Here's John Lee to try the extra point. He boots it up there, and it is good. So he is now, let's see, kicked 70 consecutive extra points. And in one quick play, UCLA scores, the defense doing it, and the Bruins lead the Cougars by a score of 10-3. A minute 26 to go in the first quarter. We'll be back in just one moment. A 66-yard return by Rutledge. Here's the kickoff now as UCLA kicks off to BYU, and the ball is kicked out of the end zone. This time it'll come out to the 20-yard line. So the Cougars trail by a score of 10-3 as play resumes. We were just talking, trying to think of the last time we could remember that happening to BYU, and I guess it was last year against Pittsburgh.
Not very often that happens. The BYU quarterbacks are Robbie Bosco the last 2 years has been almost unbelievable. And that's a very rare mistake. And I'm sure one thing about Robbie, the experience that he has and the maturity he has, that he can come back after something like that, shake it off and go down and have a great drive and continue on to a great game. Very little chance that this will bother him at all.
Oh, yeah. This is just might be the thing to fire some of the players up on offense.
UCLA, just as they lined up, called timeout. Do they only have 10 players on the field or something?
It looks that way.
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Yeah, they only have 10 players out there.
They're starting right corner Darrell Henley. Didn't realize that they were getting the ball back, I guess.
Well, they're still over there. Oh, they're talking to him, right? Send him back in there. That cost him a timeout then. There are the officials for the game tonight. Brigham Young and UCLA. Next week, Washington plays BYU right here. 1:25 the kickoff. And it'll be on ABC television, a split national telecast. Coach Terry Donahue has coached 9 years at UCLA, 71 wins, 29 losses, 5 ties, 1 loss to BYU. Coach Lavelle Edwards in his 14th year, 119 wins, 37 losses, and 1 tie. And the Cougars have won 25 consecutive football games. One of those was against UCLA.
In fact, it was very early in the streak, just after we started against the Air Force. And Bowling Green actually started the streak 2-3 years ago.
All right, the Cougars first and 10 on their own 20. They had the ball at such good field position of midfield. And a quick defensive move, they're down by a touchdown. Bellini goes in motion. Bosco gives him the draw to Haymoody. Haymoody slanting. Gains only a yard or two.
That little sprint out draw was effective against Boston College. When any team plays BYU, their defensive linemen are thinking pass constantly, pass rush. And anytime you got a team thinking, defensive line thinking that much pass rush, it's usually easy to get them upfield and get them turned. And it's very effective against the draw.
Haymoody, the ball carrier, 1 yard gain, second and 9. About a minute to go in the first quarter. Bosco back to pass on second down, flips it over the middle. That's to Hemel. He turns it on. He's out to the 40, to the 45, to the 50. It's a foot race down to the 32-yard line. What an effort by Bai Sikahema. He slipped a couple of tackles.
Tremendous play. He came out of the backfield again, made a move to the inside. Robbie's watching him all the way. He moves inside. It's called an option route. That's Tommy Taylor getting beat on the inside, and then Bai uses his quick feet to beat the tackles. A nice block by Mark Bellini, and then Vi's off to the races.
It's just exciting when Vi gets the ball. He just breaks tackles. He's got so many tremendous moves as a running back.
You know, Steve, Tommy Taylor missed him early, and he's the one that caught him. So he stayed right with it. He missed him, turned around, and caught him from
the angle.
That's
a sign of an excellent, excellent player.
First and 10, BYU on the 32. Bosco throwing for the end zone, and it is incomplete. Trying to get to Norberg, the player had touched it down. There was Turner of UCLA.
Thought it might have been a little bit of an errant pass by Robbie. What they like to do is flood that side of the field, send both men straight upfield to put the pressure on the zone defense and try to split the zone. Again, you'll see Robbie drop back, but what he's looking at downfield is two straight streaks going downfield, and he's just trying to split the zone, and maybe he saw the double coverage and then overthrew it.
12 seconds to go in the first quarter of this game. UCLA 10, Brigham Young 3. The Cougars second and 10 on the Bruin 32-yard line. Bellini goes in motion. Bosco to throw. Over the middle, complete. Complete to the 23-yard line of Mark Bellini, who just stopped and took that one.
All kinds of time for Robbie to throw that time. All kinds of time. The offensive line did a super job protecting that time and gave Robbie
all kinds of time to get that ball downfield.
Something that you'll see with BYU's offense, Jay, is Craig is, and I know Craig doesn't see this because his back's to it many times, but the separation that Robbie gets from the offensive line right away is a great sign of great protection that the offensive line is getting. Look for that break in between Robbie and the offensive line and some daylight. That shows you that the offensive line is doing really well.
Ends the first quarter with UCLA ahead by a score of 10-3. We'll return right after this. Robbie Bosco is 10 of 13, 120 yards through the first quarter. The Cougars trail, however, 10-3, but they have the ball. Third and a half yard to go for a first down on the Bruin 23-yard line.
Jay, very important play because with the new field goal kicker, not a sure thing for 3 points, and they need this first down, third and one.
Edwards goes in motion to the right. That's Sikahema trying to sweep outside. He turns the corner. He gets a block, and he's down to the 14-yard line.
I'll tell you, if you watch on the replay, Jay, you'll see number 60, Dave Tidwell, come right out of his stance and pull right straight down the line flat. And
just the top of your screen, you saw him quickly.
Yeah, the UCLA man was crashing, and he picked him up beautifully, just enough to give it to Springvi to give him that step to get him around the corner.
Tackle by James Washington. First and 10, Brigham Young on the UCLA 14-yard line. Bellini coming out wide to the left for BYU. Kozlowski over to the right side. You have Haymuli and Sikahema in the backfield. Bosco back to throw. Throws completes it right near the 10-yard line. He had to throw that one quickly. Sikahema caught it.
Again, good pressure by that defensive line for the UCLA Bruins. Another thing is, I think he was looking down to the right corner to Glenn Kozlowski on a corner route again. And they're double coveraging Glenn down inside the 20 because they know that that's where BYU wants to go with the football.
Chucky Miller in on the stop along with Darrell Henley for UCLA. Second down, 10 yards for a touchdown, 6 yards for a first down. Kozlowski will come out wide to the left along with Bellini. Tui Peluto is in as a running back now along with Haymuli. Bosco back to pass. Throws for the end zone, and it is caught for the touchdown. Hey, what a catch.
Oh, my God.
By Mark Bellini. He caught that three times.
Tremendous catch. Great call by the official down there.
Tremendous coverage by UCLA. Just right on top of him the whole way.
Watch it again. That's Bellini. He is well covered. So he tips the ball, then pulls it back and hugs it.
Beautiful catch. In fact, could have called interference on that because the defensive secondary man grabbed Mark before the ball actually got there. Great throw by Robbie to loft it up there and let Mark go for it.
Great job by the offensive line bunching everyone together and there into the middle. Just a super play.
Webster kicks the extra point, and Brigham Young has tied the score with a pretty good drive. It's now tied 10-10.
With BYU and UCLA tied at 10, place kicker John Lee pulled the Bruins ahead of the Cougars with a 35-yard field goal at the 6:28 mark in the second quarter. So with UCLA now leading BYU 13-10, we rejoin the action right here on ESPN Classic.
UCLA getting the field goal, 13 plays to move down 80 yards, 7 minutes and 15 seconds. That they run off the clock on that drive. So Brigham Young ready to receive again. UCLA 13, Brigham Young 10. The Bruins led 3-0. The Cougars tied it. They led 10-3. The Cougars tied it. Now they lead 13-10. There you see the time of the scoring drive. And Lee getting the field goal, his second of the game. He's a scoring leader for UCLA last year. We have Oates and Sikahema back deep for BYU. John Oates and by Sikahema. Here's the kickoff. Into the end zone, clear out of the end zone. So Brigham Young will take over first and 10 of their own 20. There's Tui Peluto back deep that time, not Sikahema. Here are some totals. BYU 154 total yards, UCLA 73. The Cougars have 135 passing, 19 rushing. The Bruins have 23 passing and 50 rushing.
This is a great time for BYU to get together now and put together one of those long drives that kind of takes the air out of the opposing team's defense.
First and 10 for BYU at the 20-yard line. They're on 20. Kozlowski wide to the right. Now they're shifting men all over the place. Bosco, running play, left side by Sikahema. Has to elude tackles himself, and he does, and gets out to the 28-yard line. That was a good run. He had no blocking as he got around the corner, but he still got away.
Watch on the replay, Jay and Craig, as Baez tremendously elusive. You'll see as he comes upfield, watch it right here. Watch the ball in his hand as he brings it right over the top. That's just quick feet and something that makes for a tremendous athlete.
He was tackled by Tommy Taylor. Second for BYU, 2.5 to go for the first down at the 27.5. Bosco fumbled the football, dives and gets it.
Little movement on the line before the snap might have caused that.
Looked like UCLA had just about jumped offside. The crowd is booing on it. Cougars gained a yard on the fumble. I don't think they broke the plane, however. At least the officials certainly did not think so. Lance Lindy is in as a tight end. There you see it on the replay with Bosco going down and getting the football.
What do you do on that, Steve?
Looks
just grab
to me, Robbie,
the ball and...
Looks to me like Robbie was expecting the snap count to be a different one, the ball to come up at a different time. He wasn't prepared for the football.
Robbie bootlegging, rolling to the right. He will run it himself. And he slides forward to get the first down. Out to the 38-yard line.
You know, if I recall right, Jay, I think that's called a naked bootleg by Robbie, and I think that was a very effective play for BYU 2 years ago against UCLA. And as I think about that game 2 years ago, I remember walking on the field in the Rose Bowl. I don't know if Craig remembers, but people were asking, you know, what is this, high school football day? Who's this BYU team? You know, who are these guys? And it was a great feeling to beat them down here. And here, look at that, as UCLA comes up here, maybe some of the same comments from some of the fans from BYU for what the great things that they've accomplished in the last year.
First and 10, Brigham Young at the 37-yard line. Again, the bootleg. Bosco looking to throw, does throw down
field.
He has Cause. Cause is down at the 33-yard line. Well, they're succeeding in moving everybody one way and Bosco coming back the other way. The kind of counteraction.
Exactly. They're trying to take advantage of Robbie's foot speed. Watch as he rolls left and able to throw on the run. That is a tremendous throw, difficult one to make. And there Cause finally breaking into the open. I'm sure he's glad to break the ice.
Joe Glasser tackled him. So Brigham Young trying to get in the end zone and lead for the first time in the game. First and 10 on the UCLA 32-yard line. There goes Bellini in motion right side. Bosco straight back to throw. Pumps it over the middle, complete to the Sikahema. He's to the 20, he's to the 15, he's to the 10, he's to the 7-yard line. Boy, can he go. By Sikahema, Chucky Miller caught him.
Just an outstanding job by the offensive line again. Just giving Robbie plenty of time to throw the ball.
The exact same play they've run many times in the first half already. By Sikahema on an option route on the inside, beating Tommy Taylor again. As he cuts upfield, Tommy Taylor having a tough time keeping with Vysika Hammer.
Brigham Young first and goal on the 7-yard line. 3:57 to go in the half. UCLA ahead 13-10. Robbie back to pass. The rush is on. He throws incomplete. He had to unload at that time. They really came at him.
A lot of pressure from the inside that time.
Tried to get it down to Mellini. Trevor Mellini. So it's second and goal on the 7-yard line. Wide to the left is Mellini. To the right is Kozlowski. Sikahema and Haymuli are the setbacks. Bosco to pass on second down. Looking, being chased, looking.
All day.
Now he'll run it over the sideline. Sets, lobs it for the end zone, threw it out of the end zone. Well, there must have been pretty good coverage. Look over the left.
That time they had more people down in the corner of the end zone than they did at the line of scrimmage.
Like Kozlowski was alone down on the side. How tough is it, Steve, on a play like that to pick somebody up downfield?
Well, you just look to spots and try to find a guy breaking behind an unknown. Defenders are looking at the quarterbacks. They don't see what's happening behind them. You look for a guy on your team breaking behind to an open spot and then just leading him into there, and that's what you're usually looking for.
Now Brigham Young will call timeout as the Cougars want to set up a sure thing here.
Do you get the urge to run, Steve?
Very much so.
Bosco goes over to talk.
You do.
Okay, there's timeout on the field with 3:34 to go in the half. We'll be back right after this. Third and goal on the 7-yard line for Brigham Young. Bosco asking for the crowd to quiet down. Sikahema Hemuli at the setbacks. Robbie throwing. It's caught by Glenn. He got in for the touchdown. Hey, a quick flip of the wrist by Robbie Bosco, and Kozlowski caught it for a touchdown.
What a great play. There again, the naked bootleg by Robbie gets forced very early to throw the football. Watch him right here. He sees the man coming at him. He's just going to let Glenn make a great play, which he does. And carries his momentum in the end zone for a score.
Hitting him was Joe Gasser.
You can see on this other angle, everybody just starts to flow to the right, which makes the naked possible, and Kaz just does the rest on his own.
Cougars lead 16-13. Here's the extra point attempt by Webster, and it's good. So it's 17-13, 80 yards, 2 minutes, 58 seconds, and 8 plays. And Brigham Young has the lead for the first time in this football game, 17-13.
With BYU leading UCLA 17-13, midway through the third quarter, John Lee cut the Cougar lead to 1 with a 20-yard field goal. So with BYU now leading UCLA 17-16, we rejoin the game early in the fourth quarter right here on ESPN Classic.
More BYU football. We're in the fourth quarter. I'm Jay Monson, Craig Garrick, Steve Young, former All-Americans of BYU, here to help. I guess, would you like to be down on the field, guys?
It doesn't feel right sitting up.
Well, this is a time when the friendships and the closeness of a ball club comes together because they're under tremendous pressure and they know each other what they're going to do.
First and 10 on the 9-yard line. Robbie on the bootleg, throws it, completes it.
There's that little pass Steve was talking about, the bicycle hammer. Steve called it just right on the head.
Well, they used that rollout action and the counter action, too, to open it up, and Bay caught it.
Robbie has three choices here. There's an outside receiver in Kozlowski, an inside tight end in Molini, and then the third guy coming across the field is Bay Sikahema.
Rutledge tackled him, but BYU has a first down on the 21-yard line. 13 minutes left to play in this football game.
This is a time where the offensive line says to each other, hey, guys, you got to do it now.
That's the draw. And he's up to the 30, to the 35, up to the 40, 43-yard line. Carrying is Sikahema.
I'll tell you, he's really taking control of this ball game all by himself. Catching the football, running the football.
Six.
Jeff
Look at the
Blasser
offensive
tackling.
Line. Look at Scott Robinson just move his man out of the way. Just manhandle his man. Vi puts on a few jukes and upfield. A lot of heart down there.
First and 10, Brigham Young on their own 41-yard line. Cougars ahead 17-16.
They're trying to overload one side. Look for that streak pass right up the middle.
Robbie looking, flips it, and caught by Molini. He fumbled the football, and UCLA has
it. Oh, boy. Oh, no.
That's a tough one.
Oh, no.
The Cougars bothered with turnovers, and they do it again.
Well, I'll tell you, that's just bone-jarring tackling.
They were just moving the ball, too.
Watch this. Seemed to be some kind of a mix-up. Two receivers in the same place, Steve. What do you think?
Robbie looks for the open man. He's just an outlet man. He's not really a receiver on this play.
So UCLA, they get the ball on the Cougar 46-yard line. And with John Lee, they're already a threat to score.
Four turnovers for BYU, one for UCLA.
Stevens gives on a delayed handoff. And a gain of a couple of yards by Green.
Gaston Green carrying the ball over 20 times now for under 40, just a little bit over 40 yards. BYU defense doing a tremendous job containing the speed that he has. You remember last week against Boston College, Troy Stratford had just the same speed and gave BYU a lot of problems. They've obviously changed a few things, and they've really put the clamps down on Green.
That was Kurt Gobea hit him. Second down, about 8 for UCLA.
Sean Knight in the flex position on defense.
Stevens still with the football. There's the pass. Completes it just short of the yardage for the first down.
Jay, I really don't like the way that the UCLA receivers catch the football and then are not ready to make the move upfield. You'll notice when Glenn Kozlowski or Bellini gets the football, they're always trying to make a move upfield to try to get that extra yardage. You'll see here, as Durrell catches the football, he's just content to just step out of bounds.
Carl
and
Durrell.
He can make a move upfield and maybe get the first down and puts him in a third and short situation.
Third down, less than a yard on the 36-yard line of Brigham Young.
This is where you dig in and try and bury the other guy across from you.
Oh. It's Green, and I don't know if he made it or not.
Yeah, they're going to give it to him.
Yep, they will.
That's one of those right foot, left foots.
What's that, Craig?
Well, if the official marks the ball with his right foot, you get the first down. If he marks it with his left foot, you don't.
What a boy.
First and 10, UCLA on the Brigham Young 35-yard line. As the Cougars battling themselves as much as UCLA, as the turnovers have hurt them badly. But they're hanging on to the lead 17-16. But now you're getting down close enough where John Lee can hit a field goal.
John, I would think John Lee would need about 7 to 10 more yards to be in range.
Flex position.
Pitch back, new back in the game. He's knocked out of bounds, turning the corner. That's Eric Ball. And the Bruins doing some good things.
You got to like the way Matt Stevens has got this team fired up. You also got to like the way that BYU's defense is refusing to bend.
11 minutes, 6 seconds left to play in an exciting football game. Brigham Young ahead by a point, 17-16.
You know, now the clock becomes a factor.
Second and 2 for UCLA. That defense has been out on the field a lot here in the second half. They don't make it this time.
Oh, that was just
maybe they did with pushing for it. Gouveia.
We can see that
ball
again. Kurt Gouveia. It's absolutely incredible play. He comes into blitz, slips the blocker, and lays just a beautiful hit on the ball carrier.
You know, these linebackers for BYU are really great, Jay. The thing is, in the offseason, they form an intramural basketball team out of all the linebackers on the team. They win the championship. They outmuscle, they're great athletes, and it's really fun to go watch them play.
And they outweigh the other team.
Third down and 1. Big play in this ball game. They get it. Good faking by Stevens. He faked almost a pitch out and then gave it to Greenwood coming through, and he has the first down.
That's scary, Jay, when you have everybody up on the line like that, and he breaks through that first wall. There's a great possibility or chance of him going all the way on those types of situations.
10:20 left in this football game. Well, BYU ahead by 1.
Well within John Lee's range, too.
First and 10 on the 20. That's the big guy at fullback, Marcus Greenwood, and he has 8 more yards.
I'll tell you what, this Marcus Greenwood has done a heck of a job all night tonight for UCLA. Pounding away up the middle.
Cougars trying for their 26th straight win, their 17th straight win at home. You know, this game was expected to be about a 6-point ball game, and that's what it's going to be. Second and 2 for the Bruins. That's Greenwood, and he has another first down. And boy, UCLA is on a roll. They got the ball on a turnover, a fumble recovery, just when the Cougars were moving it.
Exactly. Craig, does it look like to you that offensive line for UCLA is taking control of the line of scrimmage?
They're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage, starting to dominate the defensive linemen, which allows the running backs to get it then into the linebackers. And you can't do that. You can't do that this time in the game. This is the time where you got to dig in, decide right now that you're going to beat that guy across from you.
First and goal on the 7-yard line. Stevens, that's a pitch back to Ball. And Ball is run out of bounds right at the 8-yard line. Rob Ledenko did it.
Rob Ledanko just doing a super job, stringing it out. Everyone, Sean Knight.
Stops the clock with 9:13 to play in the ball game.
Just a power sweep.
Take a look there, Rob Ledanko just sheds his blocker and just comes up and makes a hit and drives him right out of bounds. Just super job by Rob Ledanko.
Second and goal on the 8-yard line. They lost a yard on that play.
Okay, here's a down that I think you've got to do something a little bit different than what usually is done in the past. Maybe play action fake.
Stevens will throw for the end zone. Nobody there.
That looked like there was a mix-up there, Jay. Steve?
Yeah, two players turned to the right, and there was no one where the ball was thrown.
I think what exactly they were trying to do is run a crossing route.
And they both crossed the same way.
Exactly, ran into each other.
So it's third and goal on the 8.
We never did that, did we?
Very rarely. Our guys very rarely got into trouble that way.
Third and goal on the 8-yard line. Over in the sidelines, John Lee. Who already has a 3 field goals.
Who's standing alone on the sideline, doesn't want to talk to anyone.
Big play for UCLA.
Stevens back to pass. Pressured out of the pocket, throws it and dropped.
Steve?
They would not have scored on that play. It was well covered. Mike Sherrard dropped it. Here's John Lee.
The thing about Stevens here, he makes a nice play fake, sets up in the pocket, gets rushed a little bit upfield. But he should have known on third and goal that he's got to be able to get the ball in the end zone. And if he's not going to get the pass into the end zone, at least try to run it in. Because a pass like that is not going to get you the touchdown.
Okay, Lee has made 3 field goals in the game. Perhaps the greatest field goal kicker in the history of college football. He's a senior. Kicking from the 15, a 25-yard attempt. And it's good. So UCLA has regained the lead. BYU led at halftime 17-10, but the Bruins have come back to score 9 points here, all on field goals in the third quarter, or in the second half. With 9 minutes to play, UCLA 19, Brigham Young 17. We'll be right back. Last drive for UCLA, 10 plays, 45 yards, 3:29 to get the field goal. The Cougar defense has not given up a touchdown in this game. The only touchdown was a pass interception. That's Oates taking it. Juggles it, will not run it out. And Brigham Young will take over at their own 20. And now the Cougars, with 9 minutes to play, have their backs to the wall.
You know, Jay, interesting, UCLA has had the ball twice inside the 20. BYU has stopped them. They'll give John Lee the field goal chance, but they can't afford to give him a touchdown.
Well, the Cougars, a field goal would regain the lead, but they've got to get a sustain something. They got to put something together.
Look for Vysika him on that short little pass across the middle, and then Glenn Kozlowski trying to make a big play.
Bosco back to pass on first down. Can't find anybody, scrambling, still running. Gets the pass off, it's caught. What a catch by Sika Hema on the sideline.
What a heck of a
And what
job.
A pass by Robbie Bosco.
Oh, my gosh. Robbie just did a super job.
Steve, replay, plenty of time. Good coverage downfield. That was the exact play that we were looking for. Look at Sika Hema coming across the field.
Look, they're hanging on to Robbie when he throws the ball.
Just trying in desperation to
get
rid of
it.
And look at that. What a great, great play by Sika Hema. He has taken control of this ball game. And made it, you know, without him today, I don't think BYU would be in it as close as they are.
Got a tightrope walking there. First and 10 at the 34-yard line. Bosco to pass. Now may run it. He slipped one tackle and is down. Losing yardage.
Dropped 7 guys that time, Jay. 7 guys dropped off the pass coverage.
Jim Waller made the stop. Bosco's now passed for 305 yards. And they're really putting the pressure on him.
You got to respect the speed of the defensive lineman for UCLA to catch Robbie. Robbie's not very slow. That could have been a face mask right there, Craig.
That's what the crowd was reacting to.
That's what Roger French was reacting to also.
Second and 14.
He reacts.
8:10 to play in this game. Cougars have second and 14. Now BYU calls timeout.
Now here again might be one that they might need a little bit later, yet they still have two. Might be a smart play by Robbie if he's a little bit confused.
Bosco over talking to his quarterback coach, Mike Holmgren, and also Lavelle Edwards there.
Coach French would call his whole offensive line, get them all over there, and get them fired up.
Let's thank the Cougar Club again for the financial support we receive. If you're not a member of the Cougar Club, this will be a good week to join, because if you join right now, you can get a very nice sweater, either white or blue, with the Cougar logo on it, given to you as a incentive, should we say, to join the Cougar Club.
You got your sweater, Steve?
Yes, and there shouldn't be an needed incentive. I'm telling you, with 35, very upset at this, Jay, 3,500 members for BYU's Cougar Club, there should be thousands all over the world. Now, let's get out there and join this Cougar Club, because they make the difference.
In all seriousness, I have to agree with you.
And you say it, when UCLA comes to town, the Cougar Club is there to greet them, to show them that the Pro Bowl is a great place to play football. They're treated very well from the athletic director on down by the Cougar Club. The Cougar Club is there to meet the BYU team in Hawaii and San Diego and Georgia and New York. And I think that more people need to join this organization.
And right now, one of the things financially they're involved in is to raise the money to improve the weight training facilities at the at BYU.
Which I, for one, know definitely needs to be done.
The weight training program, that's the one thing that BYU lacks, is a weight facility that's big enough like other colleges.
Super strength coach and Chuck Stiggins, however.
Second and 14 for Brigham Young. They're down by 2 points. They must put together a scoring drive. Bosco chased. There's a drop play to Haymuli. But again, they stop it. And again, you got to credit that UCLA defense.
See, you got two offensive linemen laying down. 67, Keith McCullough, and 60, Dave Tidwell. He just didn't get out there and didn't find the people and make the block.
Scott Franklin got through and knocked Haymuli down. So BYU faces third and 18.
See on the replay how they slipped right through the both of them. For that play to be effective, they've got to go out and they've got to make a hit.
7:38 to play in this football game.
Look for UCLA to double cover Glenn Kozlowski on this one.
Kozzy's open.
It's caught by Kozlowski. And it's a first down at midfield.
That is absolutely unbelievable. They know that Kozlowski's the perfect man to go to in this situation. He's the one to watch out for. They had double covered him. Glenn made a great move to go to the corner. He's wide open for on a great throw.
Joe Gasser got to him finally. Great play.
See there on the replay, Koz just wide open.
Well, Robbie had time to throw at that time. First and 10, Brigham Young at their own 48-yard line. It's going to be an exciting finish, like one of the Holiday Bowl games.
Exactly. Look for Koz again. Or the sweep.
Molini in motion. Tui Pelutu turns around the corner and stumbles forward to the UCLA 48.
I'll tell you, that's about all he could get out of that. He got about everything it was worth.
Good job by Tom himself that time. So the Cougars are now in UCLA territory. Sikahama comes back in with the play.
Both sides of the line of scrimmage are getting tired. The D-line, offensive line for BYU and UCLA. And here's where conditioning comes into point. And UCLA has been working out at sea level. BYU here at 4,800 feet or whatever it might be, the elevation might come into a factor.
Second and 6. Robbie fires. Caught by Kozlowski. He's down to the 35-yard line of UCLA.
It wasn't the cause.
Well, he's giving everybody something to cheer about now.
It's an option pass. Glenn has an option to go inside or stay outside. He stayed outside where the opening was, and he's great with the ball after he gets a hold of it.
Rutledge tackled him.
Tried to strip him of the ball, but sure-handed Koz hung on for dear life.
The Cougars on the UCLA 35-yard line with 6.5 to play. BYU trailing by 2 points. It's the draw. It's open this time to the 30. Lake Haymuli. Well, you can talk field goals, too. You know, BYU's getting within field goal range now if the drive is slowed up at all.
There's that draw trap play we talked about.
Inside draw trap play.
2nd down for Brigham Young, 5 on the UCLA 30. 6:08 left to play in a football game. Robbie wants the crowd to quiet down so they can hear his signals. Looking, looking, here's the pass.
Oh, I think it's intercepted. Got a flag, I think we'll have an interference call.
Tipped in the air and intercepted. Now a flag goes down.
This could be a crucial call in the outcome of this ball game right here.
Well, I think the flag went down after the interception.
I don't think so. I think they're going to call, I think they're going to call interference.
I think they're going to call interference.
Yep, the BYU players are applauding.
It's critical.
Here it comes. Let's see what it is. Defensive interference. It's a first down for Brigham Young. You were right, Steve.
You got to. The flag came a little bit late, but I saw the referee in the backfield trying to grab for it. He couldn't quite get it. Here you
Robbie
see the play
back.
See, Bellini is knocked. You can't see it very well, but he was knocked off balance before the ball
actually
got there.
A great defensive play, just a hair maybe too soon, and also a great interception that would have
Taylor.
First down, Brigham Young, the UCLA 20. The Cougars trailing by 2 points. Robbie says, crowd, be quiet. Running play, right side. Down to the 15. Down to the 10. Out of bounds near the 10-yard line.
That'll kill you every time.
There's a flag down.
That's got to be holding. Clipping on Scott Robinson. Clipping or holding.
Sheikha Hammett got it down to the 12-yard line, but BYU's called with a penalty.
Coach French is going to go nuts over there.
Wow. 5:46 left in this football game. And the penalty moves it back out to the 28-yard line, where it'll be first and 18.
Jay, one thing to comment on is there's been very few injuries in this ball game. With two hard-hitting ball clubs, you'd think that there'd be a little bit more injury. That tells me that both clubs are very well prepared for this opening game for UCLA and then BYU's second game.
The only one we're really aware of is Kelly Smith.
Right.
All right, BYU first at 18 on the UCLA 28. They need a field goal to take the lead. UCLA leading by 2 points. Bosco still
naked
with the football. There's the pass to Mellini. He's down to the 19-yard line. The old naked reverse, the rollout.
Mellini looks like he's hurt. He's coming off the field limping.
There's also a Bruin hurt who made the stop. Webster's over there kicking into the screen, the Cougar place kicker. BYU will have the ball second and 9 on the UCLA 19-yard line now with 5:28 to go.
Here it is on replay. You can see everybody's starting in motion to the right, and Robbie just going naked off to the left. Kind of throws a sidearm little pass to Trevor Mellini. Trevor Mellini looks like he just got his ankle caught up there in the turf.
Chucky Miller is the Bruin who is hurt. He was the one who made the first hit. We'll be back in just a moment. BYU trailing by a score of 19-17.
Here's a replay on that last play. Robbie rolling out, Trevor Mellini right there with him. He has the option to run on that play, but just dropped it off to Trevor Mellini, picked up a few yards, hurt himself and hurt another player.
Big play for the Cougars. Bosco rolling out, looking back, possible screen being chased, running for the sidelines, is down at the 22-yard line. That's not quite getting back to the line of scrimmage, so the Cougars not able to set it up.
Well,
Robbie has passed for 349 yards.
You don't like to see that, Jay. You don't like to see Robbie running with the ball with four or five white jerseys all around.
They were trying to set up the screen that time, Jay, to the opposite side. The defensive linebackers read it real well, and Robbie trying to make as much as he can. He's got to be able to get down before he gets hit, though.
Gasser hit him. It's third and 12 for Brigham Young on the UCLA 22-yard line.
Jay, I think this play is the biggest one of the game, because if they don't get this with the field goal kicker of BYU not tremendously experienced.
Bosco looks over the defense and calls timeout.
Like I said, Gary Webster, who's a great field goal kicker, but without a lot of a game experience, this could be a really tough kick for him if they don't make this first down.
Timeout, 4:25 left to play in the football game. UCLA 19, Brigham Young 17. For BYU football, the Cougars with 3rd and 12, and the biggest play of the ball game.
Oh, yeah.
Big play right here.
One of many, probably.
Bosco back to pass, looking, under pressure.
He's got Kozlowski.
Hits Kozlowski for the first down at the 8-yard line.
What a clutch player. What a clutch player.
Well, it's the Cougars to win now.
Here you see Kozlowski gets caught up in the defensive secondary. There's a mix-up. And that's a great catch.
First and goal, Brigham Young on the UCLA 8-yard line. The Cougars down by 2 points with 4:08 left to play. Bosco brings the team out. Kozlowski wide to the right. He comes back in motion to the left side. Robbie gives the ball to Shikahama. Did he score? Boy, BYU thought he was in there.
One official signaled he scored. One official signaled the touchdown.
Okay, but now they're putting the ball back outside. BYU thought they had it, but now, no. I don't think they're in there yet, although one official did signal, did he not?
Yes, the official at the top of the field did signal touchdown.
That's Shikahama. If he got the ball in there, but I guess the officials will say he did not. It is 2nd and goal on the 6-inch line. They have two tight ends in now, Mullaney and Lindley.
That was a super job by Vysika Hammett. Saw the hole, turned cutback, turned upfield, got it right down to the goal line.
That's Haymuli trying to force his way in.
I don't think he got it, Jay.
So it'll be 3rd and goal.
I think he got hit before he got his feet off the ground.
Yeah. He couldn't get any forward lean that time.
Here it is. Looks like he wants to jump. He gets hit.
It is 3rd and goal, and the nose of the football is right up by the goal line. Cougars have 2 shots at getting it in there. Now UCLA will call timeout. So the Bruins stop the clock with 3:05 to go. UCLA 19, Brigham Young 17. The Cougars maybe 6 inches away from their 26th straight win.
I think you look for this play to be Robbie Bosco on a naked bootleg or a play action, something to move him outside. I don't think BYU wants to try it up the middle again. The UCLA will be looking for that, maybe a misdirection or the naked that we've seen so many times tonight to give Robbie a run pass option. And I think that will get the score.
Coach French has called the whole offensive unit over to the sideline. He's a big believer in togetherness, and he's going to hold them together right down to the final play.
Rutledge came out of the game, shaken up a little bit. For UCLA, he's played a great game. It is 3rd and goal for BYU. The Bruin defensive unit out there, they're doing some hugging and talking and trying to make sure that they can keep them out of the end zone. So here it comes. 3rd and goal on the 6-inch line. You have Shikahama and Haymuli in the backfield. And the Cougars trying to move the ball 6 inches.
So much hanging on this play. So much hanging on this one push for 6 inches to score a touchdown.
Been quite a drive when you think about it. Some key catches by Glenn Kozlowski. Here we go.
Big play right here.
Bosco tried to bull his way in. He made it. Robbie Bosco got it over the goal line. Wow, how about that? I thought they'd stopped him.
It looked like they'd stopped him, Jay. He really took a hit after he made his initial surge forward. Someone came in from the side and just blasted him. But I think he got it in the end zone.
Well, Craig, the one thing this does is it makes it so a field goal can't beat you right now.
Exactly. They've got to go down and score. Can't rely on John Lee. Tremendous drive by the BYU offense.
Tremendous drive. 80 yards and 14 plays, 6 minutes.
Tremendous drive.
Here's Webster. That's the first score for BYU in the second half, believe it or not. And the kick by Webster is good. We have 2 minutes and 54 seconds of exciting football to play. It is Brigham Young University 24, UCLA 19.
It's a super drive.
We'll be back in just a moment. You know, they've got a great schedule basketball-wise this year, too. Oral Roberts, Notre Dame will be here in basketball this year.
Oh, that's great.
Washington.
It's always exciting.
Here's Ormsby. He bounces one along the ground. They'd like to get the clock going, make them handle the football, and they do. All the way down to the 16-yard line. Not a bad idea.
Whether that was planned or not, it worked.
I don't know. Inexperience of UCLA. The last drive, 2:54 to go, two timeouts. It would take a tremendous, tremendous effort by Matt Stevens and his offense to get the job done here.
This crowd's going to get right behind this BYU defense and fire them up and try and shut down the UCLA Bruins.
Here's UCLA.
It's so loud, I don't know if they can hear the signals being called down there.
Stevens with the ball, still has it. Gonna throw it way
He's
deep.
He's going for it all. He's got a man.
It's caught. He breaks a tackle. He gets down to the 24-yard line. How about that?
No penalty.
What
flag.
A great throw.
Boy, they did it.
Unbelievable.
All the way down
Who
to Mike Sherrard. Mike Sherrard.
I'll tell you what, that's just a great throw and
little
a great
play
pass.
Action pass.
Let him out there all the way. Sherrard just keep right in stride.
He almost went all the way.
If it wasn't for who's making
Mark
game?
Sherman.
Sherman's making a game-saving tackle.
Well, the Bruins are on the Cougar 22-yard line now. Stevens will pass again. Incomplete. No interception. Oh, incomplete. It was out of the hands of one player, and Thomas had a shot at it, but he couldn't catch that shoestring ball.
Ended up trapping it in the grass. A close,
very risky,
close play.
Very risky throw by Matt Stevens. You can see the confidence in him. He looks outside, then comes in. That ball flies right over the head of the intended receiver, and Roddy Thomas almost makes a great play. A field goal does not win this, Jay.
Second and 10 on the Cougar 22-yard line. UCLA has been down this close several times. They have never been able to get a touchdown. Stevens back to throw again. Pressure's on. He's going to run it this time. He's hit hard at the 18-yard line.
He's not going to do it that way, Jay.
Latakeo.
Couple things to remember here, Jay. UCLA is in four-down territory because of the lack of a field goal winning the football game. So they'll have two more downs inside here. Stevens makes a great play fake, and here's what Norrie didn't do last time. He wasn't able to take the yards that BYU was going to give him running the football.
Third and six on the 18-yard line.
Two downs to make 6 yards.
They're going to go up with it, Steve?
I don't think so. They got two downs. I think they can go ahead and try a running play.
Play action, roll out. He's
Here's
got a man.
It's complete to the 9-yard line. Sprouls makes the tackle.
Actually, no, Jay, time now is an ally of UCLA. Because the more time, if they go ahead and score, then with 1:41 left, BYU's got plenty of time to come back for the winning score. So
that's right.
The more time they take off here, the worse it will be for BYU if UCLA scores.
Paco Craig made that catch. It's first and goal on the 9-yard, 9.5-yard line.
All day long, BYU has held the line right here inside the 10.
It's a long 9 yards.
It's a running play.
Yes, indeed.
All the way to the 2-yard line. Good run right up the middle that time.
Jay, if I was UCLA in this position, realizing the power of the BYU offense at the 2-yard line, I'd take full amount of time before I would go run another play.
It's second and goal on the 2-yard line.
Straight handoff to Gaston Green, who just uses his power and drives right up the middle.
Boy, you thought BYU had it wrapped up, and UCLA came up with the home run.
BYU goes into their goal line defense.
Second and goal. He made it. He's in there with a touchdown. So UCLA came roaring back.
Jay, like I said, a minute two is plenty of time for the BYU offense.
They may have stopped the BYU winning streak by coming back, but there's still a minute.
Very important that the UCLA goes for two here, because one still wins it with a field goal. They've got to go for two.
Little off tackle play. He just pushes and powers his way into the end zone.
UCLA 25, Brigham Young 24. A minute and 2 seconds left to play.
Like Steve said, a minute and 2 seconds is a lot of time with the style that BYU plays on offense, and that's the thing that makes them so dangerous, is that they can score so quickly.
The Cougars had put together that great 80-yard drive to take the lead, and UCLA comes back quickly.
You gotta like the BYU, I mean the UCLA offense on that drive. Like I said, when Matt Stevens ran on the field, it would be a tremendous effort on Stevens and the offense part to come against the crowd, the tremendous enthusiasm, the winning streak, the national title, everything else, and go down and score in the face of such adversity. You've got to be impressed with that. But also, we've got to also look for the two-point conversion. A field goal still wins us for BYU without a two-point conversion.
Boy, what a football game.
One of the few great games in the last couple years in the stadium, because BYU has dominated so much.
The one thing we got to say right now, too, as you talk about the BYU program, it's at the point it can play with teams like this.
And
you're not going to win all the games.
That's exactly right, and I think that's important to realize. We're getting into a situation where we're playing UCLA and not Washington head-to-head in Boston College, and those are the times when you're going to lose once in a while, and that's going to happen. But it is, you know, look at the crowd. You don't think every one of these guys is going home and remember this game for the rest of their life. They are, and that's what makes sports so enjoyable.
Well, we're still waiting to see what UCLA will do. They do not have Lee in the game. So they are going for the two-point conversion. And then the Cougars will have a minute and 2 seconds to see if they can get down close enough for the field goal or for the touchdown.
Now, two-point conversion, like I said, Jay, is imperative for UCLA, or else a field goal wins this game.
We saw,
BYU.
Was it Alabama and
yes, Georgia.
Georgia, where the lead went back and forth
look
in the last minute.
Look for a play action here with Stevens pressing the outside.
It's a pitch back.
I was wrong.
Gaston
he
Green.
Made it. So now a field goal would only tie it. It's now UCLA 27, Brigham Young 24, as they powered it in by going to Green. 1 minute, 2 seconds. The clock does not run on an extra point attempt, so no time went off the clock.
Jay, to be real honest in this situation, I really like BYU's chances at this time, because I think UCLA will go into a prevent defense. I think that's when BYU really makes its move. The DBs will be way off. They've got plenty of time. They've got, although they've only got one timeout, they can work the clock. And if I were UCLA, knowing what I know about BYU, I would help triple cover Glenn Kozlowski and try to keep the ball away from him, because he is the man that BYU is going to look for. And although there's great players on it, you know, Mark Bellini and Sikahem has had a great game, Koz is the man that's been looked to for three years now as the big play man.
Hey, and remember, next week, we got UCLA this week, a team with a good chance to win the Pac-10. Next week, University of Washington, right here at 125. UCLA goes and plays Tennessee next week. Both teams will be playing on ABC in a split national hookup. Here's the kickoff. It'll come into the end zone. Oates, they will not run it out. They'll try and go from the 20, set it up. And Steve, there's the hurry-up offense. What we used to call it, the old two-minute?
Many times?
It's the minute and two-second offense. Like I said, Jay, I really do like BYU's chances. If I were UCLA, what I'd say is try to clamp down on Glenn Kozlowski and don't get into a prevent defense. I think that's the thing that they can't do, is get into a big prevent defense where they allow the 15 yards at a crack, because BYU can score in 30 seconds, no problem.
Well, absolutely. This is the type of situation BYU's been in several times.
Exactly.
And they've always been successful.
And I also like the fact that I'll let this play run.
Robbie back to throw. They pressure him. Here's the pass downfield, and it'll be intercepted. He threw it up for grabs in a way, and it was intercepted. And so UCLA about wraps it up.
Well, not yet. Not yet. I think that UCLA has got to get a first down to win the ball game. But the thing I want to say about that play, that's the same play that BYU ran in the first half. The two offside receivers, Bellini and Kozlowski, run straight up the field. and they're trying to split the zone. They're going for broke, basically, and Robbie knows that. And just like last week, he thinks, well, I'll throw it up deep and let Glenn Kozlowski make a great play. The problem was Glenn got tripped up, and there was three receivers down there. The same kind of ball last week Kozlowski caught for almost, you know, all the yards that he had last week. So it was a calculated great gamble on Robbie Bosco's part.
UCLA with the ball at midfield. They'll just drop on it now, and that's all. Stevens drops on it. The Cougars have one timeout left. I don't know if they'll use it or not. 46 seconds, the clock running.
I don't know why they don't use it right now. They've got to use it right now. I don't understand it. I don't understand this at all. Use the timeout, maybe a fumble, a crazy play. I hope that they're not thinking that the game's over.
27-24, UCLA leading.
I've seen crazier things. The New York Giants lost a professional football game against the Pittsburgh Steelers in the same fashion this is, when the quarterback fumbled the snap. I don't think they should give up here.
Here's a snap. He falls on it.
Use the timeout here. I'm disappointed. Do they?
They do. Yeah, they call the timeout.
All right, okay.
So they were letting the time run down on the first one.
All right.
But still, 10 seconds left in the football game. And the Bruins of UCLA have kind of quieted the Cougar crowd now. Boy, it's been a long streak.
It really has. You know, and think about the joy and the fun and the excitement. And this doesn't mar it at all, I don't think. I think that BYU's a tremendous... Not at all. I think it's going to be a tough loss to take. But it just builds moral character, Craig. I bet they come back and win 10 straight now. What do you think?
I absolutely agree with you. You just can't expect to win every single week when you're playing teams like this.
No, and I don't think you should.
You know, a 25-game winning streak is just remarkable. And where's it going to end?
Be very proud of
that. Who's going to stop
it? No doubt about
it. Where's it going to end? Somebody's going to.
Very proud of that.
Well, that should run it out. In fact, you can make a good bet there won't be an undefeated team this year.
No.
There goes the time, and the Bruins from UCLA have snapped the Cougars' 25-game winning streak by beating BYU by a score of 27-24.
I think the player of the game has to be Matt Stevens. He came in the second half, made the total difference for the UCLA offense. Player of the game in my book, no problem.
Okay, my thanks to Steve Young, Craig Garrick for the assistance during the telecast. Next week, BYU will be at home here against the University of Washington, 125 football game. Final score, UCLA 27, Brigham Young 24.